Hi, this is Jenna Jorday from Carolinas Realty, a licensed agent in both North and South Carolina. And over two-thirds of the January listings are already under contract. This is my Real Nerd Rundown, where I break down big real estate data into bite-sized chunks for buyers, sellers, investors, and other real nerds so that we can make decisions based off of facts as well as feelings. So, I was curious about how the market was going for January. And so I came up with my daily new listings scorecard. And what this is, it's available on my website. I'll put the link up above so that you can access it. It's our data that we have through the MLS. I'm looking at traditional resale homes. I exclude new construction and distressed sales because when we talk about wanting to service our buyers and our sellers, we want to focus on that traditional resale home for right now. We're looking at specifically new listings, so new listings that went on the market in January. And then listing pendings, those under contract listings, they're a subset of those new listings. We've calculated the percent pending, which is it's just pending divided by new listings. And then to add some context, the median list price. And the reason I use the median instead of the average is because medians are less susceptible to extreme high and low values. And so that they give a more accurate picture of what's going on in the market. I'm going to click back to dashboard to go back. And right now we're looking at January 1st through the 29th. For the counties that I'm particularly interested in these counties: Cabarrus, Cleveland, Gaston, Lincoln, Mecklenburg, and Union, all in North Carolina, and then York, because York is very proximal to the Charlotte area. York is South Carolina. I've added additional context, so property type, whether it's a single family residence versus a condo or a townhome, how much heated living area. Right, the size of the home, and then how many bedrooms. Above, we have general summary statistics for the new listings, listings pending, the percent pending, and the median list price, and then a daily calendar of how many new listings came on the market. And what you can do is you can click on the day, and then the summary and the context. Visualizations filter, and if I click on the day again, it takes that, it removes that filter. So what I thought we would do, one thing to mention too, this calendar is color coded. I'm using a diverging color scale. So I have hot pink as the minimum. The mean or that average is the yellow shades. And the maximum is the blue. So the closer that it gets to one of those points will kind of dictate what that color is, and that's a diverging color scheme. You can also filter it by city if you like, but for right now, I'm going to give Gaston County, North Carolina, some love because that's where I live. And compared to the 67% pending for those seven counties, we're at 73% pending with a median list price of $224,900. And what that median means is an easier way to look at it is that half of the listings in Gaston County listed for above $224,900 and half listed below. To remove Gaston County, I can go click on it again. And then why don't we take a look at York, South Carolina? York, South Carolina is currently at 68%. So today is January 30th, and I downloaded the data today, so it goes through the 29th. I hope you can see that. They're at 68% pending, and their median list price is $292,500. I'm going to click on York again to remove that filter. And then we can take a look. I'm going to give Gastonia some love because that's where I live. I'm just going to click on Gastonia and shout out there, 72% pending. And that what I find is that's just absolutely incredible statistics. So that just means the market's moving really quickly. Again, I feel like a broken record and I keep saying this, but buyers need to be prepared to buy and make an offer, and sellers need to be prepared to move and find new location as well. So it's a pretty interesting market. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Give me a like, give me a question mark, and we can touch base. I look forward to seeing you soon. Thanks.